Peter Della Penna here with USA Vice Captain Sushil Nadkarni after USA's 7-wicket win over Bermuda in their final match at the ICC America's T20 event here in Florida. You're named man of the match today. Congratulations.
Yep.
39 not out. Opening the chase. You finished highest score on the week for USA, 149 runs in 5 innings. Currently that's second overall in the event. How does that feel, considering the fact that you were out of the team when the squad was first selected 3 or 4 weeks ago?
Well, I think it's I came here with an objective and didn't get going so much in the first 3 games, and I thought I got better as the games got on, because the wickets here are not that easy to bat on. So basically, you know, I feel pretty good. There is work to do for myself moving forward. When we go to Dubai, I promise the team I'm going to come back much more fitter and leaner, and you know, because the challenge is going to be much more. But overall, yeah, I feel happy. I'm a big guy on statistics myself, so I knew exactly how much I'd scored and what my average is. But I think the team, being dropped from the team initially, I think it's motivated me a lot. So, you know, I'm back as a very motivated player for the team.
What was it like batting on this pitch especially, but over the last 2 days on this strip that was used? It looked like it was just very, very slow and the ball was not coming onto the bat. What was it like out there in the middle for you?
Yeah, I think, you know, the wickets over here were such that you never feel as a batsman that you're in and set and that you can start going for the big shots, because the ball is always keeping low and slow. So you have to get yourself in, and very early on kind of I was making up my mind on what shots I was going to play and not play. So, you know, you could be on 30 not out, but you're never in on these wickets. You still have to grind and, you know, keep going, getting the runs.
Guys, lost to Canada last night, and even in this win, there were some areas that some flaws were exposed in the team, in the batting order and also in the field. Where do you think the team needs to focus on most to improve before that tournament in Dubai starts off next year?
Yeah, I just had a chat with the team right now, but I can easily identify the biggest thing that is missing from our team right now is our fielding levels. I think talent-wise, we have a fantastic team. Guys can do fantastic, amazing stuff while batting and bowling. But it's the stuff on the field, you know, guys on the outfield, when there are certain catches which could be made, or even in the infield when certain runouts could be made, when you fumble the ball. Those little things count a lot in the end. It has a big impact on the game. And basically, that's the absolute area that we want to work on. So I'm hoping Yusaka sets up some, fielding sessions or something, brings in some specialist fielding coaches for us or something like that, which will really, really help us in Dubai.
In terms of the fielding, and you kind of hinted at, there's several times over the course of this week where there have been kind of half chances and could be turned into full chances, but players just don't get a hand to the ball or run outs, chances that the fielders are bobbling the ball, not fielding it cleanly. What do you attribute that to? Is it fitness? Is it just lack of concentration, or is it something else?
Yeah, it's something else. In my mind, it's lack of awareness of what you need to be doing, and basically lack of practice. Because when we all play in our league games, I'm pretty positive 80% of the time we are not really focusing on fielding. So we have our own little practice sessions in our local, wherever we play in the local areas, and I'm pretty sure nobody's really focusing just on fielding. I would say less than 10% of the time we spend, you know, taking catches or throwing or fielding. So I think that's the thing. It's awareness and lack of practice.
You guys finished 4-1 on the week. Unless Canada has a disaster tonight against Suriname, you'll wind up in second place. How would you evaluate overall the entire performance from beginning to end this week?
I think there are a lot of positives for the team. I know we'll come out second in this tournament, but from a big picture standpoint, the big objective was to get ourselves qualified for Dubai. And we did that. So now our focus should be on Dubai. Coming out second to Canada, yeah, you can start, you know, thinking a lot about it, but that's just one game, and there are a lot more challenging games coming our way in Dubai next year. So the focus should now be positive and move to what we are going to do in Dubai.
All right, USA captain or vice captain Sushil Nadkarni, thanks a lot for your time.
Thanks.